the famous crocodile lake. It harbors crocodiles of various sizes. Unlike in some places where such a tourist attraction is usually isolated, the Yamoussoukro crocodile lake is centrally located. One begins to wonder if it isn't dangerous to breed such carnivores in a place human beings can easily be feasted on by the animals.
It kills, but they have come to nurture them. Just like when you go to the zoo, you see lots of animals that have been domesticated. And so right now, when we get there, you will see them. The man gets along with them. He talks with them. He feeds them, you know. And so you will see how big they are. They're part of the city.
True to our guide's explanations, the reptiles act on cue. On sighting the visitors, their tema beckoned on them to converge for the tourists. The animals retire to their abode also on the prompting of the same man. Feeding of the crocodiles by their handlers is an exciting experience.
How can I do? Be able to do.
One would, however, wonder why waste live chickens on crocodiles rather than on human beings. On the road, nonetheless, sought the impressions of some of the tourists about this uncommon preservation.
This is, the main realization also of our first president. This is a cultural thing, you know. Animals like crocodiles in the lake is not a... everybody who can do it, you know. It's our culture, in our culture, to feed animals, to give life to animals. He has chosen to feed crocodiles like this in this lake, so it's a great thing for us too. You know, it's they lived here for many years.
One man entered there and he didn't eat the man.
The old man.
Yes.
I mean, it's a secret. He lives here for a long time first, and it's a secret for himself. He knows the language. He knows how to express himself.
This is wonderful. We're close to nature here, and the way this species of reptiles are preserved is something that is wonderful.
Okay, you saw them being fed.
He creates a picture of this scary picture. He just threw life out to an animal and swallows it, and that's, you know, it tells you how wonderful God is.
Does Nigeria learn from this kind of talk?
Yeah, the problem we have, especially, we don't have that culture of preservation, culture of celebrating what we have. We have a lot of things in Nigeria that the world will gladly come to look at, but unfortunately, we are not able to preserve what we have. Yeah, it's a lesson for us. We need to begin to cultivate that culture of preserving our heritage. Like, if it were in the Western society that we have places like the Osun Shrine, we have the Obodukato Ranch, we have all the sites we have in Africa, like Calabar, you know, it will be something that the whole world will look up to. But because we don't have that spirit of promoting what we have, well, there seems to be nothing.
Okay, now finally, it looks like they were caught. And they came out, you know. I mean, I just don't understand.
You know, but I don't know. But it's something that is wonderful, and the way they just congregate here, and as if somebody's commanding them. Well, it's wonderful, and it's a beautiful spectacle.
That's the march on the road could bring to you. We hope you enjoyed it.